What's up guys, welcome back to my channel and to today's video where I'm going to be sharing with you another of my absolute favorite traditional Irish recipes. This lovely loaf that you see here is Barine Brac, Irish tea bread, or Barm Brac. Oscuilge Barine Brac means speckled bread, and it gets its name because of the speckled appearance of the fruit throughout the bread. There is so much tradition, history, and folklore attached to this loaf, which is typically made around Halloween time and is often a precursor to the traditional Irish Christmas cake. And I will leave a recipe to my traditional Irish Christmas cake floating in a card above my head and also in the description box below. So in Ireland, the tradition has been to add things to your bread. For example, the most common one is to add a ring to your loaf, wrapped up in a bit of parchment paper, and the person who gets the ring is said to marry within the year. But adding a coin to represent wealth or cloth to represent poverty has fallen away a lot and out of practice in recent years. So now we are left with the tradition of the ring. And in a lot of shop-bought bracks, you will have that Barine Brac ring that everybody will fight over. I really hope that you enjoy making this deliciously rich and decadent, fruity, Barine Brac, Irish tea cake, Barm Brac, whatever you want to call it. And if you do like the video, please don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. Please don't forget to hit subscribe so that you don't miss any more of my videos. And let's get into today's recipe. Okay guys, so starting off straight away, I have 250 grams of raisins and 250 grams of sultanas in a bowl. And this is on day one of your preparation for your brac. You can also see that I have some small pieces of mixed peel here. That's completely optional. You don't have to include it and it wouldn't be part of a traditional recipe. But all I have done is I have stewed some really hot, strong tea in a pot. For this, I used 2 tea bags and 300 milliliters of water. So pop all of that lovely dried fruit into a bowl and pour over your strong hot tea. Any good Irish tea will work perfectly for this. And essentially what we want to do is let that rest overnight and allow the fruit to soak up all of that lovely liquid. And this 300 mils will actually form the bulk of the liquid for this recipe. So it is a little bit different in that respect. The following morning, you can see just how much that fruit has soaked up all of that liquid. They've become really plump and moist and juicy, and that's exactly what we want for a really plump and moist and juicy Barm Brac. And it's then time to prepare your batter. You will need 150 grams of light brown sugar, 300 grams of self-raising flour, 5 grams of mixed spice, 5 grams of salt, 5 grams of baking powder, 1 large free-range egg, your bowl of fruit, and I haven't included here that you will need about 100 mils extra of strong hot tea. So as usual, when we're doing any kind of baking, I always find it really good practice to pass all of your dry ingredients through a sieve. Give all of that a whisk together so it's nicely combined and add your sugar. That mixture is so fragrant, really you're going to love this. Now this is a bit of an unusual one, but at this point we want to add our egg and just mix it in gently. It's going to be kind of a lumpy, really weird mixture that you're not really used to working with, but trust me, it'll work. When your egg is mixed in, go ahead and drain whatever liquid is remaining from your fruit. So that fruit won't have overnight soaked up all of that liquid, so you will have a little bit left. And what we want to do is create a nice smooth batter that drops off your spoon. This is where our 100 mils extra of our strong, freshly brewed tea comes in. How much of this additional liquid you need to use will depend on how much of that strong tea that your fruit soaked up overnight. And I'm just adding it in a little bit at a time until I get the consistency that I want, which is sort of a runny, falls off the spoon cake batter, but you can still see your wooden spoon marks in your mixture. At this stage then, we can add in our fruit and just spend a bit of time mixing it in, getting everything really nice and well incorporated. It's quite a dense mixture. A lot of people wouldn't be used to making cakes or breads that are this dense, but just work with it, don't get panicked by it, and make sure everything is really nice and incorporated. So I went ahead and lined a 2-pound loaf tin with some greaseproof paper. This will just allow me to lift the bread out of the tin really nicely after our first 1 hour of baking. I'll get onto that in a second. But all you want to do is spoon your mixture in and make sure you get every little bit of it out of the bowl. We want to make sure we have all of that moisture and goodness locked in. And you're going to bake your barmbrack in a preheated oven, which is set to 170 degrees Celsius, and that is a fan oven, for about an hour. If you pop a skewer into the center of your loaf and it still isn't coming out clean, then your bread may need an extra 20 minutes. You can take your loaf out of the tin using those overhanging edges on your greaseproof paper and pop it back into the oven tin-free for about another 20 minutes, and that should do the job perfectly. There is a little bit of watching to do on this loaf, so if you notice over the hour it's becoming too brown, pop a sheet of foil over the top of the loaf and this will prevent it from browning too much. Look how absolutely amazing that looks. I cannot wait to dig into this loaf. It is so fruity, so decadent, so delicious. It is perfect to eat on the day of baking, and what we do is slather it up with good Irish butter. It's the most amazing way to eat this. And that is it, everybody. I really hope you enjoy the recipe. If you recreate it, please don't forget to tag me on social media and let me know in the comments section down below how you got on with your own bakes. If you like the video, please don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. Please don't forget to hit subscribe so that you don't miss any more of my videos. And I'm looking forward to seeing you back on my channel really, really soon. Bye.